Time and a Cherokee Young. Lane number four, the freshman from Michigan, third in the USATF 2400 meters of 2019, Zaya Holman. In lane number three, the senior from Miami, the back champion in 2019 and 2021, Olivia Bechtel. And rounding out the field in lane number two, the senior from Oklahoma State, the Big 12 champion in 2019, Aaliyah Birmingham. Women's 400 meters, heat number three.
Hold your butts.
Back to track we go for the third and final semifinal, women's 800 meters. In lane number nine, the Sun Belt champion this year, the senior from Troy, Emma Finch. In lane eight, SEC 1500 meter champion, sixth the NCAA indoor final. In this event, sophomore from Florida, Gabrielle Wilkinson. Final act of 2019, Junior Christy Schultz. field. Semifinal 3, women's 800 meters. Meyer on the inside, Miller on the outside. And then same for Keegan and Kent. That's the quartet at the front, but everybody in this race has then come through the slowest first quarter of the three in 62.01. Now Meyer with a stride ahead of everybody else. Keegan second. And that's Outback of Oklahoma State. Wilkins of Florida trying to get back into the mix, but everybody's still here. 200 to go. 133.5 left to go. Meyer, Miller, Keegan, Camp, and Wilkinson. Wilkinson and Meyer, 203.95 for Camp, does not appear to be fast enough to make it to the final. So the time qualifiers unofficially declared Seymour, Wilson Pertit, and Chippewa Maloney. Those time qualifiers to be confirmed here momentarily. Knight of East Carolina, Tidwell of Baylor, Ford of High Point, Auburn Loco of Texas Tech, Kayla Smith of Georgia, and Lauren Martinez of Arkansas. Still third attempts coming for Morgan Foster of Eastern Washington and Helen Falda of South Dakota. And then we would move to 14.75. Last jump in round two. And the women's long jump is going to move both the east and west kicks now to round three. Tara Davis is the best jumper so far, 21.43. Rhea Matthews of Georgia Tech second, and Claire Bryant of Florida third. And the top nine after this round will advance to three additional jumps in the final of the women's long jump. Time now for the
senior from Washington, 7th at the NCAA Championship 2 years ago, Darian Mills. And in lane number two, the junior from South Carolina, second in the Big West 400-meter hurdles for Cal State Northridge 2 years ago, DeAndrea Young. Women's 400-meter hurdles, top two from each heat, was the next three fastest to the final.
Jumping is completed at 14.1 and a quarter. Moves the fourth height of the day, 14.3 and a quarter. Seven women remain in the pole vault.
Side, lane two, DeAndrea Young. Three, Mills. Four, Stubler. Five, Langley Walker. Six, Milan Young. Seven, Bernard Joseph. Eight, Russell. Nine, Henderson. Going out well is Brittany Humphrey in 7, and also Brooke Overholt from Cornell, and only her third meet of the year in lane 5. Also moving well, Felicia Chambers from Kansas State in 8. And Shannon Weisberger of Arizona making the big move on that backstretch, and it's Weisberger in the lead, and lane 6 for Red Bull, Arizona. It is Weisberger as we come to the stretch. Weisberger in 6, and Brittany Humphrey in 7, and also moving up to lane 3, the 2 is Faith Ross from Kentucky. It is Weisberger and Ross, and look, it's going to be right, oh, and it is Brittany Humphrey. 56-56 for Humphrey, Weisberger 56-63. Faith Ross will make the final, 56-68, unofficially, of course. Stephanie Pichella will make the final, unofficially, 57-64.
While we wait for those results, we'll look at the scoreboard on the right. right side of the screen, those are the combined results. The top nine that will advance to three additional rounds of jumping. They'll reverse the order, so Ruth Tesoro of Texas Tech will jump first of the order. And the last jumper in the final three rounds will be the current leader of the event, Georgia freshman Jasmine Moore. Best of 21.8¼. Round four beginning shortly.
I'd like to introduce you to the center of the field where we have the test for the shot put final. Flight number one will be on the east ring, flight number two on the west ring. The final will be on the east ring. We advance the nine best after tie breaking to the finals after three throws. Let's introduce you to flight number one. Throwing in the first position, sophomore from Indiana, eighth in the NC2A's, last time they were held in 2019, Madison Fowler. Throwing second, the junior from Arizona State. She just broke the collegiate record in the distance at 230 feet 4 inches. She broke a 40-year-old record. She's the world leader this year in the distance, and in the shot put she was third in the 21 NC2A indoor. Yorinda Van Klinken. Throwing third from Texas, the senior, the Big 12 discus throw champion in 21, Elena Bachrupper. And lane number four, the junior from Alabama. She's won five MEAC championships in various events for Florida A&M. For Alabama, she was second in the SEC Hammer Throw Taylor Corps. Throwing fifth, the junior from Ohio State, the NC2A indoor champion, Adelaide Aquila. And lane, throwing sixth, excuse me, the junior from Kansas State, fourth in the NC2A shot put in 2019, Taylor Latimer. And the seventh throwing position, the reigning NCAA champion of 2019, from when she competed for Arizona State, now competing for Arizona, Samantha Nome. Throwing eighth, also throwing in the javelin, the sophomore from North Dakota State, fifth in the NC2A outdoors in this event in 2019, Keely Moten. Throwing ninth, the senior from Iowa, the NC2A discus throw champion in 2019, and third in the USATF meets in 18 and 19 in that event, Bolaga Sasaga. Throwing 10th, the senior from Indiana, 8th on the all-time collegiate list at 62 feet, 1/2 inch, Caleb Dawson. Throwing 11th, the junior from Ohio State, 6th in the Big Ten shot put, Divine Oladipo. And throwing 12th and last in flight number one, the junior from Tennessee, the three-time SEC champion, Latavia Maines. Now let's introduce you to flight number two. Throwing first, the three-time NBC champion, the senior from Southern Illinois, Adrian Moore Jones. Throwing second, the sophomore from Clemson, third in the ACC shot put, Veronica Fraley. Throwing third, the freshman from Iowa, qualifying for her first NC2A championship, Kat Moody. Throwing fourth, the sophomore from Kent State, sixth in the NC2A indoors, the shot put this year, Gabrielle Bain. Throwing fifth, the senior from Ohio State, third in the NC2A shot put in this event, the last time it was held was 2019, Shawnee Olatoy. Throwing sixth for Alabama, third in the SEC championships, Nicolette Dunbar. The seventh thrower, the senior from UTSA and the Conference USA shot put champion, Maya Campbell. Throwing eighth, freshman from Ole Miss who qualified for the shot, discus, and hammer, Jelani Davis. Throwing ninth, the sophomore from Wisconsin, third in the Big Ten this year, Josie Schaefer. Throwing 10th, freshman from Virginia, fourth in the ACC, Maria Diaz. Throwing 11th, the sophomore from Oklahoma, the Big 12 runner-up, Peyton Montana. And throwing 12th, the senior from North Dakota State, second in the Summit League Championships this year, Shelby Gunnels. What a great shot put this is going to be.
And to the far side of the field we go, the women's 200 first of three semifinals. Lane number nine from Coastal Carolina, the Sun Belt champion, Melissa Jefferson. Back to the track, third SEC performer, LSU junior Simone Mason. In lane seven, the MEAC champion from North Carolina A&T, Cam Sturgis. In lane six, the Big 12 indoor runner-up freshman, Corona Davis. In lane number five, twice an NCAA champion, finished fourth at the World Championships in 2019, USC senior Angie Analyst. In lane four, the Big 12 runner-up. She's also broken the Irish national record this year. Freshman from Texas, Rashida Aleke. And in lane number three, three, third Pac-12 championship this year, junior from USC, Lene Kayla Thomas. Semifinal one, women's 200 meters. Semifinal number one underway here. Out in lane eight, this formation of LSU. Taylor Brown Ennis and five have come away in middle of the track for the lead. We have Sturgis, North Carolina, and T-Chan. Sturgis now for the lead. And they will be the two that I'm after to advance the final. Sturgis and Ennis. 22-55 for Sturgis, who will win the 0.9 meters per second. And the second in 22-70, and Bigley, Texas, 23-5. Hold on now to the right of the afternoon, 14-5 in the quarter. We're down to five women in the competition. Lisa Benson of LSU, Lauren Martinez of Arkansas, Summer Knight of East Carolina, Tuesday Tidwell of Baylor, and Caleb Smith of Georgia. And in the javelin, a big first round throw for Arizona State senior, Elise Menard, 190 feet, Eva to go into the lead. Marie Therese Post in second at 185.1. Soro of Texas Tech opened up the fourth round of jumping, top nine now, the final of the women's long jump as we go back to the track, and semifinal number two of the women's 200 meters. In lane nine, seventh of the SEC championship this year, LSU freshman Thelma Davies. In lane eight from Cincinnati, the American Conference runner-up, Asia Chandler. In lane seven, the Pac-12 champion this year, NCAA indoor 60-meter champion in 2019 from USC, is senior T.T. Terry. In lane six from Alabama, two times the NCAA indoor runner-up, the SEC champion outdoors, junior Tamar Clark. Lane five will be vacant. In lane four, fourth of the SEC championship from Arkansas, Jada Baylor. In lane three from Tennessee, who is eighth at SEC final, senior Maya McCoy. Lane two, the MEAC runner-up this year from North Carolina A&T, sophomore from the end of those apps. Semifinal number two, women's 200 meters.
On your mark.
T.T. Terry in lane 7 for the win of Troy on this side of Tamar Clark of Alabama. 56 for Clark. 0.4 meters per second. Tailwind, TC Terry at 22.76. And Baylor to Arkansas third, 23.19. So Gunnarsson, the only woman over the bar on first attempts at 14.5 and a quarter. Second attempt upcoming for Martinez of Arkansas, Knight of Eastern East Carolina, Tidwell of Baylor, and Smith of Georgia. Tyra Kitten is next on the runway in the long jump. Keely Moten, who is simultaneously competing in the shot put and javelin, leads the shot put at 55.75 early in round one. Semi-final number three, the women's 200 meters. In lane nine, the ACC champion. Seniors from Miami, Alfreda Steele. Lane eight, from UNLV, Northwest runner-up this year, senior Cassandra Hall. Lane seven, she's the Big 12 indoor and outdoor champion this year, sophomore from Texas, Kennedy Brown. In lane six, Big Ten 100 and 200 meter champion, senior from Ohio State, Anadia Battle. In lane five, she's a semi-finalist for Nigeria, the world champions in Doha in 2019, now a freshman at LSU in favor of Ophiri. In lane four, six, the Big 12 championship, Oklahoma sophomore Kennedy Blackman. In lane three, making her first NCAA final weekend appearance, freshman from Stanford, Alexa Russell. And in lane two, for the MEAC championship, freshman from North Carolina A&T, Joa Ross. Semi-final number three, women's 200 meters.
On your mark.
Semi-final number three underway. Cassandra Hall, I start in lane eight for UNLV. And final of Texas. Time of the day. like those advancing by virtue of finishing first and second in their respective heats, and the small cues, those advancing on time. Cycle through one more time on that first page, the important one, the nine qualifiers, including Steele, Davis, and Hall, the time qualifiers in the 200.
We're at round three, flight two in the javelin. Opus Georgia still leads at 191.10. The big mover is Laura Fiamancini of Bucknell, the lifetime best 185.4 to move into third place. Menard of Arizona State still holding down second.
And the white flag goes up for our leader in the women's long jump, Jasmine Moore of Georgia, completing her fourth round jump. Get only one legal mark for her today, 21.8 1/4, but that is the lead by four, a little less than 4 inches over Tara Davis of Texas.
Champion this year, Georgia is your leader at 75-54. Aiden Owens, Big Ten champion from Michigan, 210 points back at 73-44. Marcus Balaji of Arkansas, courtesy of a big second day, is moving to third at 72-09. Texas freshman, Lugelauer, is in fourth at 70-87. Oregon's Box Baldwin is in fifth at 70-72. Luke Daniels, senior from Iowa, at sixth at 7,046. Alex Kieran Thomas of Auburn, seventh, 7,036. Eric Booth, Long Beach State, 69-63. Wade Walder of Michigan State, 68-99. And rounding out the top 10, going to the 1,500 meters, Isaiah Martin, 68-63. And our hit numbers, Lugelauer hit number one, Kieselmeyer hit number two, Owens three, Martin four, Balaji wears hit number five, Swaby six, Tilka hit number seven, Daniels at eight, Wilmer at nine, Walter at 10, Baldwin wears hit 11, Spiridonitis 12, Fred at 13, Bruce at 14, Farmer at 15, Orkis wears hit number 16, Tony at 17, and Darren Rogers. The opening 400, 68-4 for Owens.
tries to join her to the next height in the competition.
Hold it up! Let's go,
man! And final results about the Catholic. Bob Gore. Kyle Tilga, Georgia, was your winner at 82-61. Aiden Owens, the runner-up, 81-14. Allergy will finish third. You see those results populating up on the video board. Kyle Tilga, this year's MWF champion and the CAF champion.
And here's Carmen
Ames.
Round 5, the first
leader, and that's Lexi Thomas.
freshman from Georgia, Jasmine Moore. In second place, the runner-up this year, Texas A&M junior, Tyra Gittin. And the second person to wear a cowboy hat on the top of the podium in 2 days, and the NCAA outdoor long jump champion for 2021 with a best of 21.11¾. Congratulations to sophomore from Texas, Tara Gittin.
Samantha Nome of Arizona improved in round four to 56.7½. Almost exactly the same as the previous. 7. Going in round number 5.
scoreboard, please note from an earlier result in the division where in P1 of the women's 800-meter semifinal, we had a disqualification between the Andagano of LSU. In the result of that disqualification, a 10th athlete will be added to the final. So the large huge numbers completing or qualifying, moving on by virtue of their top finishes in their respective heats. And on the third page, you'll see Fazio advancing as the result of that disqualification. 10 women in the final of the women's 800 meters on Saturday.
And the shot put, round number 5, the collegiate leader, athlete Aquila of Ohio State, moves into the lead at 59.7.5.
And back to the track for our final racing of the afternoon. It is the first of three semifinal heats in the women's 4x400 meter relay. In lane number 9, the Big Ten runner-up, Purdue. In lane 8, the Big 12 champions this year, Texas. In lane 7, third SEC championship this year, South Carolina. In lane number 6, third NCAA indoor championships and their runner-up in 2019, University of Arkansas. Fifth NCAA championships in 2019, in lane number 5 is Alabama. In lane 4, the ACC runners-up this year, Virginia. In lane 3, North Carolina A&T. In lane 2 will be South Florida. Semifinal 1, women's 4x400 meter relay.
South Carolina.
South Carolina and Texas and Alabama. Those are your top three. Will be top two automatically advancing Saturday's final. Stephanie Davis from South Carolina. Brooke Jaworski of Texas. And Baker of Arkansas.
Semifinal number two, women's 4x4.